into two categories. Okay, that may be like perfect competition market and imperfect competition market. About the perfect competition market, we discussed in the earlier class. Okay, today class we'll talk about imperfect competition market. Okay, yeah, as we know that this imperfect competition market, whatever we are talking about is imperfect competition. Okay, competition market. So this imperfect competition market are divided into four categories. That is a monopoly market, and another is what is known as a monopolistic competition market. Monopolistic competition market. And duopoly and oligopoly. Okay, duopoly and oligopoly. So like that, this market are divided into this imperfect competition market divided into different categories. Again, the four categories. So in today class, you are going to discuss about the monopoly market. In the imperfect competition market, there are four categories. Out of these four, this is the one of the thing called monopoly. So about the monopoly market, we will try to discuss here. Okay, what is monopoly? Monopoly market is one of the most important market in the world. Okay, monopoly, nothing but mono plus poly. So yeah, mono, nothing but single. Okay, poly, nothing but seller. Monopoly, nothing but single seller. Monopoly market, nothing but single producer. Single seller will be there in the market. So that's why the monopoly, nothing but a market structure, it is characterized by a single seller and selling a unique product in the market. Okay, there will be single seller in the market, and that single seller is selling a unique product in the market where there is no substitution for that commodity. Okay, there is no substitution for their commodity. So in a monopoly market, the seller faces no competition, because here we are saying that there is only one seller. There is no competition for that seller, since he is only one person is there in the market. So no competition is there for that one. And the sole seller, that is single seller, are goods with no close substitution. Whatever the goods are selling by this seller, the solo seller, single seller, you have no close substitution, no substitution. It is identical commodity. It is the same commodity selling in the market. So no substitution commodities, and there is only single seller in the market, we can say. So a monopoly market makes a single seller the market controller as well as the price maker. Please remember here, a monopoly market makes the single seller the market controller as well as the price maker. So this single seller, he will control the market. He will control the price, he will control the production. Everything will be controlled by this person. He will be decide the price, he will be decide the output. Both will be, market will be controlled. So he enjoys the power of the setting the price for his goods. So he is the complete power to setting the power of the price. So that is what you can say that. So he can decide the price. Okay, he can decide the price. He can control the market. He can control the price whenever he want. If he want, he can increase. He can decrease. He can decide the output also. Everything will be so decided by this person only. That is the monopoly only. Okay, whenever we are talking about this monopoly, there are different types of the monopoly: private monopoly and public. Public monopoly. Public nothing but government. So monopoly nothing but single producer, single controller or single seller. If the government is the government is controlling the market or organization, that is called like a public monopoly. For example, railway transport, one of the best example. Railway transport is the one of the example for the public monopoly. Private monopoly. So if the private people is managing the total market other than the government, that will come under the private monopoly. And the pure monopoly and imperfect monopoly. So in the pure monopoly, there is no close substitution. There is a single seller, complete no substitution. And whereas in the imperfect monopoly, actually there is a single seller, but there may be like a substitution, but not very close substitution. So there may be like some of the goods maybe give the same utility. Maybe substitution will be there in case of the imperfect competition market. Simple monopoly, nothing but there will be uniform price for all the consumers. There will be single seller. Seller is selling the commodities to all the consumers with the same price. Is known as a simple monopoly and a discriminating monopoly. So here there is a single seller, there is a same identical product, but the seller is selling his commodities, the same commodities to the different consumers with a different price. Okay, there will be different price in case of the discriminating monopoly. Natural monopoly. Legal, natural, nothing but so automatically the nature will be controlled. Legal, that means government act. Through government act, if any people will get the monopoly power, that is technological, that is a patent. So who are having the patent, right? So on that particular, the particular commodity will not produce by another. So like a technological and a giant monopoly. Giant public and private people are two or three people jointly can be have this agreement to produce the same identical commodities. So like that, the monopoly can be divided into different categories, can say. And the features of the monopoly. Okay, whenever we are talking about this monopoly, so the features of the monopoly, nothing but so as we know that there will be single seller in the market. Okay, no? Two or more sellers, only single, solo seller. Okay, solo seller or single seller will be there in the market, and a large number of buyers will be there. Okay, seller is one, but when I'm talking about the buyers, there are many. Okay, large number of buyers will be there, and no substitution commodities. Whatever the goods producing by this buyer, like seller, that goods don't have any substitution. So substitution. And there is no difference between farmer industry. Whereas in the perfect competition market, the farm is different from the industry. But in the monopoly market, the farm and industry both are same. The farm and industry, both are same. So that is one we can see. And the no freedom to entry and exist of the farm. Okay, since here there is only one industry, that is also called a farm. Here there is no enter to the new industry and exist also. Okay, if new industry will enter, it will come under the duopoly again. So here there is no another seller, only one seller will be there. That's why new companies will not come and new industries will not enter in the market, and the existed in seller will not exist from the market. And nature of the demand curve. The demand curve, it is equal to okay, so the nature of the demand curve. The demand curve will be the downward slope in the monopoly market like this. The demand curve. Because whenever there is a more price, here in the monopoly market, the monopolist or single seller can decide the price. He can decide more price. When the monopolist or seller will have the more price, the consumers may purchase very less commodities. This is the demand. No? Okay, if the seller will decrease the price, the demand will increase for the commodities. So whenever the price decreases, the demand for the commodities will increase. So that's why the nature of the demand curve will be downward slope from the left to right. Okay, left to right. So that is also called AR curve. That is also called a price curve. Price curve, AR curve, demand curve, both are the, or these three are the same. Okay, price is equal to average revenue, that is equal to demand. All this will be same, they will be like this. Okay, downward slope from the left to right. Okay, why the demand curve, price curve, AR curve, they are the downward slope from the left to right. So as said just now, so the monopoly seller, he can decide the price. When if you want more price, you will increase the price. When the price will increase, what about the demand for the commodities? The demand for the commodities will be decreased. If you want to sell more commodities in the market, he has to reduce the price. Okay, he has to reduce the price. So whenever the price is coming down, the demand will increase. Okay, demand will be increases. So that's why, if the price increases, the demand will come down. If the price decreases, the demand will go up. Price is equal to average revenue. What is the average revenue? It is the revenue receiving by the seller by selling one commodity. Okay, it is the revenue earning by the seller by selling one commodity. So one commodity income, nothing but price of that commodity. Once commodity income is equal to AR, that is average revenue. Okay, one commodity income, nothing but price. That's why average revenue is equal to price. Average revenue is equal to price. Okay, there will be downward slope. At the same time, whereas the marginal revenue curve,
also downwards flow. See, margin revenue also, they are the downward slope like this one, but it is less than AR. So yeah, it is what is called less than AR, we can say. So if this is the average revenue curve, this will be the marginal revenue curve. The both are the downward slope, both are the downward slope, but MR is less than AR. You know, in the first semester, when we discussed about the revenue curves, so there you may had about that discussion, marginal revenue and average revenue. Okay, so once again, I will try to explain this one. So this is the thing, why the average revenue curves will be like that. Okay, to understand that one, so this is the number of commodities, we can say this is called demand, we can say. This much goods are selling or supply. We can say X supply. This is the price. Okay, price. So yeah, who will decide the price? We know that the price will be decided by the producer only. The price will be decided by the seller only. But whenever you want to sell more number of commodities, you have to decrease the price. So if you want more price, you can sell the less commodities. That is what I told you. Yeah, the one more point, please remember, the both output and price will be decided by the producer, seller. But both at the same time cannot decide. Suppose I am the seller, I am the single monopoly in the market, no competition for me. Now I want more price, I can decide. But at the same time, here, if I will decide more price, the people may not purchase more number of commodities. That is the point. Suppose if I want to sell more number of commodities in the market, what I have to do? I have to decrease the price. So that's why here, the both price and output will be decided by the producer, no doubt at all. But both at the same time cannot decide. If you want more price, there will be less demand, less output. If you want more output, so you have to decide less price. So this is also, you please remember in the exam writer. Suppose this is the price level. Okay, whenever the number of commodities, you want to sell more number of commodities in the market, so is decreasing is price level. Price level is decreasing. So this is the total revenue. Total revenue nothing but P into Q. Okay, this is the Q. This is the P. So one commodity into 20. So 20 rupees is the total revenue. Two commodities selling with 18 rupees, 36 is the income like that. Average revenue. Average revenue, nothing but it is the income for one commodity. So we will get the total revenue divided by number of commodity. This is the total revenue. This is the number of commodity. 20 by 1 is equal to 20. This is the total revenue. 36 divided by 2 is equal to 80. 48 by 3 is equal to 16. 56 by 4 is equal to 14, something like that. Okay, we will get the average revenue. So this average revenue is equal to the price level. Average revenue is equal to price level. And what is called marginal revenue? So what is the marginal revenue? Marginal revenue is nothing but delta TR divided by delta Q. That is the change in the total revenue divided by change in the total number of commodities. Marginal revenue is nothing but additional revenue from the in the total revenue. Okay, it is additional revenue in the total revenue. That is what we get. So this is the 20. So what is the additional one here? Yeah, 20, it is 36, nothing but additional is 16. So your additional is 12. Your additional is only 8. Your additional is only 4. Your additional is 0. Because here 60. 60 minus 60 0. So yeah, this is actually is minus 4 plus something like that. So yeah, AR is decreasing, MR also decreasing. But MR is decreasing more than the AR. Suppose here from year to year, AR decreased only 2 rupees. But here MR was decreased 4. Here AR was decreased only 2, but whereas MR was decreased 4, please remember. So whereas here 2, here the 4, 2, 4, 2, 4, 2, 4. So here MR was decreased more than the average revenue. So that's why here we are saying that whenever we are talking about this one, if this is the average revenue curve, the MR curve will be below than MR curve. MR curve is below than the AR curve. Okay, MR will decrease more than the AR, so like this here. Yeah. This is the AR, that is the MR. MR is below than the AR, please remember. It is 18, it is 16. MR is less than AR. It is 16, it is a 12. So that's why the always the MR is what is called less than the what is called AR, what we can say. Okay, AR is less than the MR. Okay, this is the average revenue curves and model revenue curves. We know that, as we discussed earlier, in the first semester also we discussed it. And even yesterday class also I told you. So average cost and marginal cost. What is the shape of the average cost and marginal cost? The average cost and marginal cost shape of the U shape. Okay, if this is the average cost, this is the marginal cost. Okay, I told you the difference between average cost and marginal cost in the first semester and even yesterday also I explained. So these are the average cost and marginal cost curves. These are the average revenue and marginal revenue curves. Okay, once you know this one, yeah, what is the condition? Condition to know the firm equilibrium, price determination. How the price will be decided? Okay, how the price will be determined? Okay, where, otherwise we can say that where output or firm will be decided. Okay, firm or output will be decided, we can say. Yeah. Okay, yeah, whenever we are talking about this particular aspect, just say if this is the average revenue curve, this is the marginal revenue curve, average revenue curve and marginal revenue. Okay, these are the average cost curve and marginal cost curve. If you join these two, then we can understand the firm equilibrium. Okay, what are the conditions? Conditions to know the equilibrium. Okay, to know the equilibrium. What are the conditions to know the equilibrium? Nothing but here, where MR is equal to MC and MC is touching the MR curve. Okay, MR curve from below. Okay, MR should be equal to MC. That is, the marginal revenue should be equal to marginal cost. And marginal cost curve should be touching the MR curve, that is marginal revenue curve from the below. Okay, there firm will get equilibrium. Okay, farm will get the equilibrium. To know the equilibrium of any farm, this should be the condition. That is, MR should be equal to MC, and MC should be touch the MR curve from the below. So this is the primary condition. Okay, where this condition will be satisfied, there the farm is going to get the equilibrium. So at that point, what is the price is there? And how much output is selling by the company or farm or industry? Okay, that price is a profitable or not? Okay, at that point where the farm is getting the equilibrium, at that point whether the farm is getting the abnormal profit or normal profit or loss. So that is the point we have to know. So here we know the other condition is if AR is equal to AC, then the firm is getting normal profits, you know, normal profits. So if AR is more than AC, the firm is getting abnormal profit, abnormal profit, super profits, more profits. If AR is less than AC, then firm is incurring the loss. Firm is running with loss. Okay, the firm is running with loss, what we can say. That is a, so that's why if we combine the both, okay, if we combine the both, this will be the condition. So this is the, what is called a OY axis. Okay, this is called a OX axis, where we will discuss the output here. That is the production. Here, the price will be decided. Price. Okay, PP, like price will be decided. Okay, this is the average revenue curve. This is the marginal revenue curve. Why the these curve shapes will be like that? Already I explained. Even today also I explained in the table and the diagram also. Okay, these are the average cost curves. This is the marginal cost curves. Okay, first of all, we have to know that where the firm got the equilibrium. To know that one, the, what is the condition? MC should be equal to MR. Okay, this is the MC curve, marginal cost curve. This is the marginal revenue curve. Marginal revenue curve. At this point, the both MC are equal to MR. Okay, in this point, MC became equal to MR. The marginal cost curve is touching the MR curve. And this is also touching the MR curve from the below, you know. That's why firm got the equilibrium here. Okay, firm got the equilibrium with this much production. Okay, at this point, what is the price? To know the price, what we have to do? We have to draw this line up to price line. What is the price line? This is the price line. AR curve is nothing but price. AR curve is nothing but demand. Okay, price is AR, AR is a demand, you know. Okay, so if we draw this line up to price, this is called price line. Okay, this much price is there for the production. Okay, this is the price. Okay, this is called AR. Okay, it is called maybe P. So P is equal to AR, we know. Price is equal to average revenue curve. Okay, that is the point. Then we have to know the cost. That is average cost. Okay, this is the average cost curve. Okay, this average cost curve is touching this one here. Okay, this is the cost to produce each and every production. The average cost nothing but per unit cost. Per unit cost production. So this is the per unit cost production. Okay, this is the AC. R is the AC. Okay, R, this is the Q. QR is the AC. QP is the AR. Okay, QP is the AR. Okay, since A, like the okay, AR is more than AC. Okay, this is the AC. From here to here, AC. But AR nothing but this one. Okay, there, from here to here, AR. From here to here, AC. AR is more than AC. Then what we can analyze? When AR is more than AC, the firm will get the abnormal profit. That is the firm will get more profit. Firm is getting the more benefits, more profit. What we can say. So like that, so the firm, we can say that the firm got the equivalent abnormal profit. In the short run, the industry may get the loss, may have the normal profit, but in the long run, in the monopoly market, always will get the abnormal profit only. Because in the long run, there is no seller, no, so you will try to capture the total market and you will try to increase the price and you will get more benefit. So this is how the firm is going to get the equilibrium, price is going to get the equilibrium. So all this dotted area is called a profit for the industry. Okay, profit for the industry, you can say. So this is a dotted area. So like that, we can analyze this price determination in this one. In this monopoly market, we have the monopoly power. Okay, we have the concept of the monopoly power. So monopoly power, nothing but here. So in the monopoly, the both firm industry are the same, already we discussed. So in the monopoly market, the both firm industry are the same. The both price and production will be decided by the monopolist only. Both will be decided, but both cannot decide at the same time. That is also, you know, if you want more price, there will be less production. If you want more production, he is going to decide the less price. So if you want more price, output may be low and vice versa. So in this particular case, so the freedom of the power to decide the price level is known as the monopoly. Okay, the freedom of the deciding power of the price is called monopoly power. So he is having the complete power to decide the power. But the point is only cannot decide at the same time. That is the point here. Otherwise, he is having the complete power to decide the power actually. So this is called monopoly power. Generally, since he is having the monopoly power, so what he will do? So he is going to discriminate the price. First, see, for example, I am the single seller. There is no competition for me. I have the complete power to decide the price. There are different consumers came to me. I can sell the same commodity to different people with different prices. Okay, the same commodity, I am selling with different prices. That is known as the price discrimination. What is called? Price discrimination is charging different prices for the same product on the same price for the different product. The price discrimination is the charging different prices for the same product at the same price for the different product. What we can analyze. So charging the different prices for the identical product is called price discrimination. Okay, so charging different prices for the identical product. Product is same, but the different price is charging. That is called price discrimination. So generally, the more price will be decided, the market where there will be inelastic demand. Okay, see, for example, inelastic demand. What is the inelasticity of demand? Inelasticity of demand, nothing but even though price is changing more, the demand is changing very less.
So whenever the price increases, the demand may be decrease very less. That's why the percentage of change in the price is more than the percentage change in the demand. So in this particular cases where there is an inelasticity of demand for the commodity, so there the producer will decide more price for the product. And you will decide less price where the more elasticity of demand for the product. More elasticity is nothing but the demand is changing more than the price. So in this particular case, what you will do? You will decrease a little bit price. If you will decrease the price, the demand will be changed more. So that means by decreasing less price, you will try to sell more product in the market. So that's why in this case, the price will be less. Okay, in inelasticity market, the price will be more. You will try to sell less product. In the elasticity of demand market, the price may be decreases very less, and you will try to sell more product in the market. So like that, so you will try to sell more product, and finally in both market, you will try to get more profit. In inelasticity of demand also, so even though he is selling less commodities, but since the price is very high, he will get more profit. In the elasticity of demand, the price may be less, but he is selling more number of commodities in the market. That's why in that way, you will get more prices also there. That is the price discrimination, we can say. And one more concept is called bilateral monopoly. Bilateral monopoly, nothing but generally in the monopoly market, more number of one seller, more number of buyers will be there. Already I told you in the characters, there will be one seller, but more number of buyers will be there. But in case of the bilateral monopoly, okay, bilateral monopoly, so in a bilateral monopoly exists to mean now, a market has only one supplier and one buyer. Only one seller, one buyer. Only one producer, one consumer. One seller in the market, one buyer in the market. So that is called a monopoly, bilateral monopoly. So the one supplier will tend to act as a monopoly power and look to charge high prices to the buyer. Okay, since he is the only one seller, he will try to sell his product to with more prices. And the lone buyer will look towards paying a price that is as low as possible. So since he is the, see, from the seller, since he is the only seller, what he will do? So he will try to sell more his commodity to the buyer with high price. But from the buyer side, what he will do? Since he is the only buyer in the market, so he will try to pay less price to the seller. Like that, there should be bargaining power between buyer and seller. So in somewhere the price will be decided and he will purchase, he will sell. Okay, single buyer is known as monopsony. Single buyer is known as monopsony. Single seller is called monopolist. The both will be enjoyed in this market, what we can say. Okay, so like this, we discussed about the perfect competition market, PCM, nothing but perfect competition market and monopoly. So if you see, there is some differences between perfect competition market and monopoly market, something like that. So in the perfect competition market, we can see there are large number of buyers, okay, large number of course, sellers. So here the large number of single seller. In the monopoly market, there will be single seller, and the large number of sellers will be there. But the buyers are more in both conditions. Okay, in the perfect competition market, P is equal to AR, AR is equal to MR. Okay, and they are horizontal to OX axis. But here, P is equal to AR, of course, but AR is more than the MR and they are downward slope. So I told you like that. So this is the AR, this is the MR. But in the perfect competition market, I told you that, so this is the price, this is the AR, this is the MR, everything is same. And no advertisement cost. Here, there is no substitution commodities.
There will be homogeneous product we can see in the perfect competition market. But here there is no substitution, there is identical, there is no identical commodity. Firm is price taker and industry is the price maker. When we discuss about the perfect competition market, okay, firm will price taker only, but the firm is going to be, the industry is going to be decide the price. Okay, now perfect knowledge about the market. There will be perfect knowledge about the market for both consumers and buyers, but whereas there is no knowledge about the market condition for the seller and the buyer also in this market. Okay, this is somewhat the differences between what is called a monopoly and a perfect competition market. So regarding this particular topic. Okay, on this topic, if you have any doubt, please. On this topic, you have any doubt, please ask me. Thank you.